Hello everyone, now we will be starting with superficial mycosis. Okay, so superficial mycosis includes your surface infections and aapka cutaneous infections. Okay, the surface infections and cutaneous infections. So let's see what are the surface infections. Surface infections first. Okay, so we have got first tinea versicolor. Okay, tinea versicolor is caused by what? Malassezia furfur. You have to remember this. This comes as an MCQ. So tinea versicolor is caused by Malassezia furfur, and it presents with hypo or hyperpigmented scales over the trunk, chest, and upper back. So it may be hypo or hyperpigmented. Okay, hypo or hyperpigmented. I will show you the pictures. See, this is the chest and the back. See, hypopigmented. This is hypopigmented. So this is tinea versicolor. Okay, hypopigmented. Okay, so this is tinea versicolor caused by what? Tinea versicolor caused by Malassezia furfur. Okay, Malassezia furfur, you have to remember that. Okay, so now lab diagnosis. How we will do the diagnosis of tinea versicolor? So we will take some skin scrapings. Scrapings of the skin should be taken. Scrapings of skin. Then these scales are put in potassium hydroxide, 10% potassium hydroxide. And what we will see? We will see spaghetti and meatball appearance. What we will see? We will see spaghetti and meatball appearance. We'll be discussing this in our image-based discussion. Okay. Then scales plus, when the scales are added seen in wood lamp examination, we see golden yellow fluorescence. Okay. Golden yellow fluorescence. And the scales are added with SDA, that is dextrose agar, in olive oil overlay, we see fried egg colonies. So remember, fried egg colonies are also seen in mycoplasma, which is a bacteria. Okay, so what we have to remember from this: tinea versicolor in potassium hydroxide shows spaghetti and meatball appearance. Then in wood lamp examination, it shows golden yellow fluorescence, and in SDA, that is Severance dextrose agar, it shows fried egg colonies. Okay. Now, what is the treatment? It is treated by selenium. Selenium. Kya hai? Sulfide. Okay. It is treated by selenium sulfide. Now, tinea nigra. What is tinea nigra? Tinea nigra is found in palms, face, and fingers. And it is caused by, this is very tough to pronounce, Phyonelomyces wernicke. Okay, Phyonelomyces wernicke. It is caused by what? Phyonelomyces wernicke. It is also caused by Cladosporum wernicke. Okay, and it is also caused by, other name is Exophila wernicke. Okay, so you remember W. Okay, tinea nigra, you remember this W is there, so that's enough. Wernicke, whenever and Wernicke is involved, you know it, that it is tinea nigra. Fine. Now pidra. What is pidra? So there are two types of pidra. One is black pidra and one is white pidra. Okay, so black pidra is caused by pidra horti and white pidra is caused by trichosporon bijli. So how we will remember hot? Something gets hot, like you burn something in your kitchen. So what color it will be? It will be black, right? So hot is black. Okay. And bijli. Bijli in India is lightning. So lightning is what color? Lightning is white color. So white color is, white pidra is bijli and black pidra is hot, and hot is black. Okay. So pidra occurs in hair nodules. Okay. Next. So this is a picture of your arthrospores of Trichosporum bijli. These are arthrospores. Okay, so these are arthrospores, arthrospores of this Trichosporum bijli. Okay, bijli. Yes. Okay, and number two, this is an hair shaft showing black pedra. Okay, this is a hair shaft showing black pedra. Fine, understood. Now some diseases we'll study. Now tinea capitis. What is tinea capitis? Tinea capitis is involves the scalp. When this is some form of ringworm. Okay, when it involves the scalp, it is called as tinea capitis. Tinea barber is related with beard. Okay, tinea ungium is ungli. Like in Hindi we have ungli is in nail folds. Okay, then manum involves hand. Crudis involves groin. Okay, groin, dhobi or jock itch, this is important. So groin is known as tinea crudis, and it is also known as dhobi or jock itch. I'll show you the pictures of each and every one of them. Tinea pedis is foot. So it involves foot. This is known as athlete's foot. Tinea corporis involves non-hairy regions of body. Now we will see each one of them. Tinea capitis. See, this is the ringworm of the scalp hair. See this one. So this is tinea capitis. Okay, this is tinea capitis. Fine. This is also tinea capitis. So there are two types of tinea capitis. One is fibrous and one is carrion. Fibrous is dense crust formation on the scalp. See, there is some crust formation in the scalp. So this is fibrous. Okay, this is fibrous, and this is painful boggy swelling over the scalp. So this looks painful, right? Dekhne se lagta hai painful hoga. So this is boggy swelling and some boggy swelling over the scalp. So this is known as carrion. So tinea capitis kya kya hota hai? Fibrous and carrion. Okay, remember this. Okay, then fibrous is caused by Trichophyton schoenleni. Okay, fibrous is caused by Trichophyton schoenleni, and carrion is caused by Trichophyton verrucosum and T. mantagrophytes. Okay, now what is the treatment? Removal of hair and application of topical antifungal agent. Okay, now this is tinea corporis. Tinea corporis involves non-hairy skin of the body, that is trunk and the limbs. Tinea corporis kya hota hai? It involves non-hairy skin of the body, that is trunk and your limbs. Okay, this is trunk and the limbs are non-hairy, right? So it involves the non-hairy portion of the body. Fine. Then tinea pedis. This is also known as athlete's foot. Tinea pedis kaha pe hota hai? Pero pe hota hai. Pedis is leg. Okay, tinea pedis is leg in the foot. Sorry. Now tinea crudis. So this is the groin. Groin mein it is also known as jock itch or dhobi itch. Fine. Then tinea barber, you can remember barber, what they do? They trim your beard and mustaches. So barber happens in beard and mustaches. Okay, and tinea facie, then it occurs in the non-bearded area of the face. Tinea imbricata, these are concentrated lesion of the skin caused by Trichophyton concentricum. From the name only itself we can understand that concentricum. Okay, tinea Trichophyton concentricum. Okay, Trichophyton concentricum. tinea ungium, we told that it involves the nail beds. Nail beds, ungli, nail beds. Okay. Next, tinea manum. Manum is palmar aspect of the hand. You see in the palm. Okay. Then dermatophytes. We have to study dermatophytes. Dermatophytes involves the skin, hair and nails. Okay. Microsporum. There are three types of dermatophytes. This is trichophyton, then microsporum and epidermophyton. So trichophyton, it in tri is there, so three. Okay, involves skin, hair and nail. All the three are involved. Skin also, hair also and nail also. Microsporum. Microsporum involves skin and hair. Here M is there, so N is not involved here. So M and N are not involved. Okay, microsporum, nails are not involved. Epidermophyton, it involves skin and nail, and hair is not involved here. Hair is not involved in epidermophyton. Okay, so these are other names. So these are the shapes of the different dermatophytes. Trichophyton is pencil shaped. You remember, it comes in your exam. These pictures may come. Trichophyton is pencil shaped. It has lot of microconidia. Okay. Then this one has only macroconidia. And microconidia is absent. And this one is spindle shaped. This is club shaped or boat shaped. Okay. Let's study this. So trichophyton is cylindrical in shape. Cylindrical in shape. It has numerous microconidia. Microsporum is spindle shaped and it has less microconidia. Epidermophyton, club or boat shaped, and it has absent microconidia. Okay, so here perforation test is positive in T. menta growths.
Start preparing for the NEET MDS from your home. Dr. Pranab Academy of Dental Sciences. Online classes for all first, second, third and final year students. NEET MDS online test series, unlimited practice and highest quality teaching. Affordable pricing. Download the app now.
Now, opportunistic mycosis. These are the opportunistic mycosis: candidiasis, cryptococcus, zygomycosis, penicillosis, pneumocystosis and fusariosis. Okay. EID reaction. EID reaction, dermatophyte EID reaction is the hypersensitivity to fungal antigens. Okay, so what is EID reaction? EID reaction is hypersensitivity to fungal antigens. Okay, now we will study about subcutaneous mycosis. What? We will study subcutaneous mycosis. So it involves subcutaneous mycosis involves skin and subcutaneous tissues. Okay. So what does it involve? Skin and subcutaneous tissues. So what are the subcutaneous mycosis? We remember by the mnemonic MRCS. It is mycetoma. Okay. Rhinosporidiosis, chromoblastomycosis, and then sporotrichosis. So now mycetoma is also known as Madura foot. Why it is known as Madura foot? Mycetoma is also known as Madura foot because it was found in the Madurai district of Tamil Nadu. Okay, so there are two type of mycetoma. One is actinomycetoma and one is eumycetoma. So actinomycetoma, you have to remember that it is bacterial, and eumycetoma is fungal. Okay, actinomycetoma shows multiple sinus and swellings. In eumycetoma, there are single sinus and swelling. Actinomycetoma, there is purulent discharge. So there is discharge. In eumycetoma, there is serous discharge. Then Actinomycetoma, there are white yellow granules caused by Actinomadura madurei and Nocardia cavae. Okay, and you have to remember this Actinomycetoma, white granules, and also it shows red granules. Okay, and red granules by Actinomadura pellitteri. So, this is a NEET PG question. Okay, this is coming exam. So here black granules caused by Madurella grisei and Madurella mycetomatis. White granules caused by Acrimonium and Pseudoleucheria boidi. Okay. Next, the Actinomycetoma granules are crushed granules and seen under microscope. It shows less than 2 micron bacilli. Less than 2 micron bacilli. Okay. And it responds well to antibiotics. Okay. This Actinomycetoma responds well to antibiotics. You have to remember that. Remember it by heart. Actinomycetoma A4. Actinomycetoma A4 antibiotics. It responds well to antibiotics. Okay. And on X-ray, it shows osteolytic lesion. Lytic means kya hai? Jo lytic means lysis. Lysis of the lesion. Matlab, there are two things, osteolytic and osteosclerotic. Sclerotic means deposition and osteolytic means removal. Okay? So in U-mycetoma, we see crushed granules and seen under microscope greater than 2 micron hyphae. Greater here. Here less hai, and this is bacilli and this is hyphae. Responds very poorly to antifungals. Antifungals say very poorly response. And U-mycetoma, see U is there. We need amputation. U is there, you need amputation. U is there, you need amputation. You have to remember it like that. And on X-ray, what does it show? Osteosclerotic lesions. Now, let's see what is botryomycosis. Botryomycosis is also a mycetoma-like lesion. It is seen, it is caused due to Staphylococcus aureus. Okay, botryomycosis is what? It is mycetoma like lesion and seen in Staphylococcus aureus. Okay, next, this is chromoblastomycosis. Chromo means what? Color or pigment. Okay, so this is pigmented fungus. Okay, pigmented fungus, it occurs due to thorn prick or wood prick. It is a dermataceous fungus, involves skin and subcutaneous tissue, and it shows what? Sclerotic bodies are seen in tissue biopsy. Brown colored globose bodies. So see, these are brown colored globose bodies. Huh? These are also known as sclerotic bodies. Sclerotic bodies. Okay. These are also known as brown colored globose bodies, and also these are known as copper penny bodies. Copper penny bodies because it looks like a copper penny, right? Ek rupiah, do rupiah ka sikka jo hota hai, it looks like that, right? So also it is known as medullar bodies, copper penny bodies. Examples are Phyllophora and Cladosporidium. I have given this. I have shown this picture to you two times in the previous slide also, this slide also, because this is a very important question and it comes every year or the next in NEET PG. Okay, now rhinosporidiasis. Okay, rhinosporidiasis is caused by Rhinosporidium seaberi. Okay, Rhinosporidium seaberi. Now it is no more considered as fungus, but most of the people, they considered it as an aquatic protozoa. Okay, aquatic protozoa. Why does it occur? It occurs due to taking bath in stagnant water and like holy dips is a risk factor. It presents with bilateral nasal polyps. Rhino say hum kya, like what we can relate rhino with, related with nose, right? So it causes nasal polyps. Okay, rhinosporidiosis causes nasal polyps. So in polyps biopsy, the jo nasal polyp hota hai, uska hum biopsy karte hai. Then what do we see? We see spherule. So see, this is a spherule And which is this? There are endospores. So sporule with endospores is the किसमें होता है आपको राइनोस्पोरिडियोसिस में, राइनोस्पोरिडियोसिस. ओके, स्पेरियल विद एंडोस्पोर्स. ओके, व्हाट इज द ट्रीटमेंट? डेप्सोन दिया जाता है, बट द बेस्ट ट्रीटमेंट इज पॉलीपेक्टोमी. मतलब बेस्ट ट्रीटमेंट मीन्स टू रिमूव द, सर्जरी करना, रिमूव द पॉलिप. ओके फाइन. नेक्स्ट, नाउ स्पोरो ट्राइकोसिस. इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज रोज गार्डनर्स डिजीज एंड इट इज कॉमन अराउंड वैलेंटाइन डे. व्हाई इट इज कॉमन अराउंड वैलेंटाइन डे? देखो, रोजेस दे आर प्लक्ड ड्यूरिंग द वैलेंटाइन्स डे, राइट? तो इन इन दैट टाइम दिस दिस डिजीज अक्वायर्स मोस्टली ड्यूरिंग वैलेंटाइन डे, रोज गार्डनर डिजीज, बिकॉज रोजेस आर प्लक्ड ड्यूरिंग वैलेंटाइन डे. सो इट इज कॉज्ड बाय स्पोरोट्रिक्स शेनकी, शेनकी, ठीक है? Caused by Sporotrix shankii. I don't know how to pronounce it. Whatever you pronounce it, the pronunciation won't be taken into account while you are appearing for your NEET PG or NEET MDS examination. What matters is you are able to mark the answer correctly or not. So increased incidence in and around Valentine Day. Walking barefoot in Himalayas is a risk factor caused by thorn prick and it has lymphocutaneous spread is seen. This you have to remember, lymphocutaneous spread is seen. So it is a dimorphic fungi. We know that sporotrichosis is a dimorphic fungi. So in yeast form it exists as a cigar shaped, and in mold it appears like a flower like sporulation. Okay, so in sporotrichosis we see asteroid bodies. What are asteroid bodies? Asteroid bodies pata hai aapko, like asteroid bodies, see, this is an asteroid body, like a star. So this is an asteroid bodies. Okay, and then we also see splendor Hopley phenomenon. In sporotrichosis we see splendor Hopley phenomenon, fine. So we have to remember the splendor Hopley phenomenon is seen where we see it in sporotrichosis. Okay. Next. Now deep mycosis mein kya aata hai? Histoplasmosis is also known as darling disease. Histoplasmosis is also known as what? Darling disease. Okay, and then it is caused by Histoplasma capsulatum. It occurs due to aerosol transmission of pigeon feces. Okay, feces of pigeon. Okay, next. It shows pulmonary involvement, hematogenous spread, and visceral involvement. We have to remember these things. Then yeast form is narrow-based budding yeast cells. In yeast form mein hum kya dekhte hain? Iska aapka budding yeast cell, and then tuberculate macroconidia is seen. Okay. Then histoplasmic mimics TB in presentation. TB in presentation. So histoplasmosis is similar to TB. Okay, so we'll study little bit in detail about this. Okay, so histoplasmosis ka pulmonary, it causes pulmonary disease. Okay, so there are acute form and there are chronic form. Okay, acute form is influenza like disease. Okay, it resolves within 2 to 3 weeks and shows lymphocyte rich infiltrate in lungs. Chronic shows hemoptysis, apical cavities, and calcification. Okay, it resembles what? It resembles TB. So we have to remember this, that it resembles TB. Then aapka histoplasmosis also shows cutaneous and subcutaneous disease, like it causes petechial lesions. Then it also causes disseminated disease. What are the disseminated disease causes by histoplasma? One is anemia, number two is leukopenia, number three is hepatosplenomegaly, and number four is multiple lymphadenopathy. Okay, ठीक है, तो क्या क्या है यहाँ पे, what we have studied, that आपको क्या है, histoplasma shows pulmonary disease, acute and chronic form. Acute is influenza-like disease, resolves within 2 to 3 weeks, shows lymphocyte rich infiltrate in lungs. Chronic form, we see hemoptysis, apical cavities and calcification, and it resembles aapka TB. Okay, then cutaneous and subcutaneous, we see petechial lesion. And disseminated disease mein kya hota hai? Anemia, leukopenia, hepatosplenomegaly and multiple lymphadenopathy. Okay, so how we will diagnose? Now iska lab diagnosis kya hai? Lab diagnosis of histoplasma. Lab diagnosis, how do we diagnose? We take the sputum because it involves the pulmonary involvement, then sternal bone marrow, and we also take the lymph nodes. Okay, we do the lymph node biopsy. Okay, so microscopy is done. Kaise karte hai microscopy? We use Jimsa stain, then we use Gram stain. Okay, and it shows microscopically, what does it shows? Intracellular, you remember, intracellular, okay, just a minute. So it shows intracellular oval budding yeast cells. फिर से लिखता हूं मैं, what does it shows microscopically? Microscopically क्या करता है? I think I won't be able to write again here. Microscopically it shows intracellular oval budding yeast cells. Okay, okay, ठीक है, fine. Next, now we come to blastomycosis. So blastomycosis is also known as North American Chicago or Gilchrist disease. So Gilchrist was an Adam Gilchrist was a very good player from Australia, right? He used to blast, right? He used to hit sixes and fours. So we can remember like that, blast is related to Gilchrist, huh? North American. Now he was an Australian, now he has shifted to America, North America. Australia, North America, language ek jaisa hai. No, they speak English, not ek jaisa. Their language are different. English may be bahut differences hai. So Australia, from Australia, he has shifted to America. And America mein kaha pe rehta hai wo? Chicago pe. Okay? So Gilchrist used to blast. Now he has shifted from Australia to North America and he stays in Chicago. Okay? So it is caused by blastomyces, dermatitis, and yeast like yeast cell look like figure of 8 appearance or broad based budding yeast cell. So see, this is figure of 8. This picture you can see, this is figure of 8, right? I'll get the pointer here and show you. See, this is figure of 8, right? So this is blastomycosis. So how we will remember that blastomycosis may figure of 8 hai? How to remember that? It's very simple. See, just a minute. This is not working. Why? Okay. So B, you write down B. And B, you can write it down like this also. B is similar to 8, right? B or 8, if you write B like 8, this is also 8. Write it like down. So B, 8, 8 shaped, figure of 8 shaped, okay? So blastomycosis, okay? Then coccidioidomycosis, it is caused by coccidioidis imitis. It is used as a bioterrorism agent. Then in the mold, see arthroconidial arrangement. See, this is the mold form and it shows arthroconidial arrangement. These are arthroconidial arrangement. And yeast, spherule with endospore. So this is a spherule. Let me get the pointer. This is a spherule with endospores. Endospores inside. Okay. This is coccidiomycosis. Okay. Now paracoccidiomycosis. So paracoccidiomycosis is South American disease, also known as Lourdes mycosis. So it is caused by paracoccidioides brasiliensis. It is yeast Mickey Mouse appearance. See this, or mariner's wheel appearance or pilot wheel appearance. So see this. This is a like wheel appearance, right? This marine, like what they say, ship. The ship, they have a wheel, right? The driving wheel. It looks like that, mariner's wheel. Okay, and it also look like this also, Mickey Mouse, this head, you see Mickey Mouse, this one. It looks like Mickey Mouse also. And pilot wheel, pilot's wheel. So, ship ka jo pilot hota hai, uska wheel ki tarah ye dikhta hai. So, it is also known as pilot wheel appearance. Okay. So, penicillosis now. It is caused by Penicillium notatum. It is common among HIV positive patients. And it produces brick red color pigment. And it shows brush conidial arrangement is seen. Okay. So this is all about today's class. In our next class, we will study Candida and other organisms, other fungal organisms. So we'll stop here. Thank you very much.